Grubby, please be the dad I never had. Okay, go to your room. Owen 23, Volovin, Cypher, Neltarion, versus Hrothgar, Ridzu, Dadalia, Verdant, and Doge. I am the banner of Stormwind. Sky Temple. I am in my room. Okay, let me get the belt. Oh, never mind. Let's see. Sky Temple. I ban first what? Rag? The Haka? Maybe I ban the Haka. Jaina first. Balloon. Grant
hell, it's about damn time.
Interesting. What do we combine it with? Which specialist is most conducive to cooperate with Jaina? I could do Abathur. Turns out it's Zul. Actually, Devouring Maul would have been a pretty sick combination. I just wanted to go for Eeny Miny Mo because I couldn't decide. Will you buy Zul's Master Skin? Is the Pope Catholic? Let's see, what do we ban? What do we ban? What do we ban? What do we ban? Which warrior really dominates? So probably Diablo or ETC. Ban the warrior meta. Artana, Sonya, ETC, Dahaka.
Let's fly.
Diablo would be a very good last pick for them. It would be nice if we could have it. Yes. Diablo and Zul'jin. I like it. I like it. What is the Master Skin like? Okay, that one. Yeah, Master Skin's pretty nice. You head for Valera! I mean, she's got more health than an Anubarak, so I guess she's a pretty okay solo tank. They have Zarya. We already have a warrior, guys. It's okay. And the funny thing is, this guy, I know he knows better than this. I might just play specialist the rest of the day. Medivh, Zagara, Hammer. I love specialist. I think it's my favorite role.
Retreat is in order.
Your right to fear me
Have you tried with guillotine build, Onzo? Is it any good? No, it's no good. Good start. We got 10 souls for Diablo. What's your Zul build, Grubby? Think deeply while having a frowning face for about 7 seconds every time we level up to a crucial tier. Then pick something based on my gut feeling or by misclick. And hope that my waves of skeletons will swarm the opponent into submission. Let's start thinking about our level 4 so that we have more time to feed once we get there.
The light of the sun grows within
the worthwhile.
Soon they shall bask in the light.
I'm not sure. Not quite sure. Are you 12 years old, right out? If so, I'll forgive you your cringing.
I need help. A balance will be preserved.
I went for Death Reach. I'll go Q build. I like full Q.
Stay right there. Go into the blackened night. The familiar scent of death.
Ouch. We got it? Nice.
Thank you. Healer
of magic subsides. A retreat is in order.
Find something else to fight over.
I'm a little bit low. I need to walk past Brightwing.
Thank you, healer.
What's your opinion on Nazebo? I love Nazebo. I think he's really fun. I was afraid they ruined him with the rework, with the Q aiming. It's not quite that bad.
Capture this mercenary camp. No.
He's gonna Hearthstone for mana anyway, so it's better if he tanks.
You die.
Harvest Vitality, weaken. or the healing. I'll get weakened. Less attack speed for them. I'll be a real spooky Zul. Nice damage. Oh, what is... Not a bad idea. A little bit too late, but pretty cool. The thing is, though, he'll probably lose the fort due to it. Now, I can choose to get level 10 mid or to help fight. I'm going to choose to help fight. I may have chosen wrong. I don't know.
I sense death within this place.
Because Zul relies on hero level advantage, he's not quite as useful in fights as others. So I think I chose wrong. He's an excellent duo laner and I'm not really fully making use of that. False thought with a vengeance, saved fort, pushed back our fort.
The journey begins.
Oh. Wow.
Thank you,
I contributed! Yay! let's see, Brightwing has ZZZ build? Yeah. My build has zero synergy, by the way, but I still like it. Like, I took the poke from the Q, then I took the hard engage from Weaken, and the hard engage from Backlash. So it's not really synergistic. Also, no skeleton synergy, but I like it anyway. I think it's good. I can poke or I can go in hard. Gives me two modes of operation. Damn you, Thunderstrikes! Always tracking me. Wow, nice chase. Decrepify, giant curse corpse explosion, I get decrepify. Let's turn them into decrepits. Wow, he's low. He's low. So people ask me how do I contribute with Zul in teamfights and stuff, and I always think the key of Zul, because he's such a good laner and duo laner, the key is to do get that hero level advantage before fighting, not to fight too much at equal tiers. Seems wrong to kind of leave, but I feel like I could and should. I'm not sure if it's right though. I felt like we could probably disengage. Didn't have to take the fight. I may have made a wrong decision, but at least it was a decision. I didn't have the full overview that we're going to be Ring of Frost mid lane engaging. I'll admit to fault. I did ping that I'm leaving. Doesn't make it right per se, but it doesn't make it wrong per se either. Normally it showed skeletal mages, now it doesn't. It's weird.
Someone's been practicing.
Thank you. EU gust, right as we can potentially take the boss. Gonna go for flowing wounds. Nice. Gets the vision, I get the shield, so I'll tank some on my shields. Love those Twilight Dream attempts. Do you get a Q reset per hero or just for one? Not just for one. That was a nice feed. Oops. I thought we'll push with it instead of taking a camp that will arrive staggered and do nothing by itself. Since we're, you know, 4v4 and we have the boss, but I did see my team is going for the siege, and I was like, I can always just use my myriad of teleportation skills to escape, and my delusion was bursted. It was a pretty stylish feat. I did make a few skeletons, probably added at least 2% damage on that keep.
The great cycle of being begins anew. I stand sentinel.
Oh, nice Brightwing pushing with this.
My magic flows through the temples.
Guardian!
Do not let these mortals approach them.
The journey begins. You will be made silent.
Brightwing solo versus Falstaff. Okay. Probably he used Gust to interrupt Emerald Wind.
As you say. Go into the blackened night.
Diablo versus Tychus.
Quaint, but useful.
Slowed.
I sense death within this place.
How long do you think it takes to learn HOTS properly? I'll let you know when I learn HOTS properly, Mahoney. I've been playing for 2 years.
As
Ouch. Oh, that hurts. I would say about 10,000 games should do it. 10 to 20,000 games. Uh-oh, Spaghetti-O. Oh, nice kill. That was so nice. Of course, he'll probably die for it. No, he won't. That was beautiful. Oh, cleansing shield.
My temple's power has been expended. You are stronger than I believe.
We're stronger than he believes. Nice. No, we do need 20. Run? When is the boss again? Oh, 1 minute? Yeah, like 50 seconds. I need my mortal wound level 20 to reach my full power. Not a good situation when you're level 18 till... Versus 20. Dracula's blade whispers your name. As you say. Why did you start playing HOTS? Because I enjoyed it. I tried it and I enjoyed it so much. That was such a nice gift.
Still a few tricks up my sleeves.
A balance will be preserved. Assist me.
No. Two skeletal mages, nice. Nice job, Jaina. I love those curse sounds, man. I have my full power now. I took Mortal Wounds, so I have full Q build. This gives me 75% reduced healing taken on all people that I cast it on. Nice curse. Finish it. Okay. Scary stuff.
Greetings, friend.
And such a short cooldown as well. Yeah, we can win with Bolt, that's true. On my way. Hey, Meow Meow, thank you for subbing, dude. Uh-oh, Spaghetti-O. Man, the healing reduction is super nice, and the frequency of the Qs that I can cast with 40% slow. Yay, level 10 Zul.
Dracula's blade whispers your name. Forward unto darkness. Meet your death.
Level 10 Zul.
Greetings, friend.
Sup. Vohio. Sure. Jaina played nice too. So did Sol'jin. Master skin? Nah, I got the scarecrow. The pumpkin scarecrow. Ta-da. You just want me to spend my gold. Backlash. Weaken. Honestly, I don't take the backlash for the damage. I take it for the frequency. Shade blocks all auto attacks, which is really nice. But you can only use it once every 50 seconds. And this is once every 30. I'd rather have a decent shield every 30 for free than an amazing one every 50 that also doesn't deal damage. And this one, Weaken, was to try and reduce the damage of Zarya, Tychus, Falstaff, and Valyra. If I ever have to solo them, or I'm relatively near. The cool thing about sweeping strikes is that if you cast it on a minion in front of you, and there's a ranged hero behind it, it has such a big scything area, sweeping area, that you're very likely to hit them as well. People rarely expect it, account for it, or dodge it. Now, normally you have a 40% auto attack speed slow, which is relevant, but it's not, like, oh. 75% though? Nice. I do think that Shade is a bit over-nerfed. It used to be from 30 to 40 seconds, and now it's from 30 to 50. I think it should be 45. The slowing bone armor is, in my opinion, underwhelming. It's a 1 second slow for 35%. You have to chase someone to slow them, but... no. It's like a very small radius. I don't think it does enough. 15% damage with backlash is much better than a bit of slow. You can slow in other ways. There's so many slows in the game. It's better because it adds damage. You've got double warrior, a specialist. You need to start becoming a ranged assassin here. So I would really like you to get expulsion zone. Shorter cooldown, which means more effective in the randomness that is low level hero league and quick match. It does actual damage, so you contribute with that. You can save your teammates. This is like, I imagine my team will perfectly follow up. I understand why you did it. It's like, oh, you know, Chromie's going to get a lot of damage. But she's got her own setup with Temporal Loop. And you knew that because she got her ult at 8. If you do Expulsion, this zone is blocked. This zone is blocked. It's amazing.